Hey YouTube, what's going on? So, I'm gonna go over my experience that I've had with my Dodge Ram 1500 with the 5.7 liter Hemi. Now mine is not a four-wheel drive pickup truck. I live in an area where we don't get much snow, a couple days a year maybe. I keep a set of chains in the truck just in case I get somewhere where I need them. But for the most part, I didn't have any need for four-wheel drive when I bought the truck, and I got it for a really good deal at the time. I've had the truck now almost 4 years. It'll be 4 years middle of October. And I've got about 86,000, 87,000 miles on it. When I bought the truck, I was right at about 52,000. So I'm not quite putting 10,000 miles a year on the truck, which is crazy for me because I used to commute for the first, I'd say 10 years, 15 years of my working career, working life, 12 years I'd say, my working life, I commuted back and forth to work, a fairly long distance. So at least 30 miles each way, and in some cases 60 miles each way. So I'm used to racking up miles on vehicles relatively quickly. So for me to be under 10,000 miles on a vehicle a year in the time that I've owned it is amazing to me. So, but I do pull a 31-foot RV. Now, the gear ratio in my rear end is 344. And I would like to have had 372s or 373s. But they only offer that in the four-wheel drive. Now, I could replace the gearing in the rear end if I really wanted to, but it's not been that big of a deal. It pulls my trailer very well. I pulled it over the mountains just fine. The one thing about the 5.7 liter Hemi, and actually even the transmission that comes in here, which is the, I believe, the 46... R46LE or something like that. It's as long as you treat it well, it'll treat you well. And what do I mean by that? Regular maintenance. I have at 60,000 miles, it had to have a tranny service. It had to have a all new filters and all new fluid. The motor had new spark plugs put into it. Or the engine had new spark plugs put into it, and just basic maintenance. As long as you keep up on your basic maintenance, since I bought the truck, I've only ever ran synthetic through it, and I run the exact viscosity that they suggest or say that you need to run through it. As long as you do that, it'll treat you well. Now, if you start abusing it, they do have a habit of having issues. I put a extra large transmission cooler on this thing. I wanted to basically have ice cubes coming out of the transmission pan if I were to drop it after a trip. Because with pulling a pretty large trailer like I do, I wanted to make sure that it would not hurt the transmission at all. And so I had an extra large tranny cooler put on it, aftermarket tranny cooler, and it's got a oil cooler. I have the oil changed regularly. I use full synthetic, and it has run well. Now, the issue that some of these trucks have is that the heads the oil ports on the heads are really small. And if you don't keep the oil changed regularly and you don't do the things necessary to keep your to keep it cleaned out, then you'll run into those getting blocked and you'll seize up your motor. I've seen these trucks go for 200,000 miles as long as they're well maintained, and I've seen them break down at 50 or 120,000 miles. So as long as you as long as you take good care of it and treat it right, it'll treat you right. You know, do your due diligence. Like I said, this is a 2006. I did all the research on it to find out what are the issues that this truck has for that model year, and I do my best to make sure that I cater to those issues and take care of it. I get the rear end diff changed, fluid changed out regularly, and I just make sure everything is well maintained, and it has done well. It's can be expensive to do like the 60,000 mile. If you take it into a dealership to do the 60,000 mile service on it, you're talking $1,200-$1,300. So I would suggest finding a mechanic that you can take it to them, and they'll oftentimes do it a lot cheaper, save you a few hundred bucks on that. Or even taking it to your local Jiffy Lube or something like that. The issue with taking it to Jiffy Lube is most of those places, most of those oil change places are not set up to be able to change the spark plugs, because on these Hemi engines there's two spark plugs per cylinder, and so they're oftentimes not equipped to be able to handle that. So, but if you take it to a regular mechanic shop, you'll probably save yourself a bunch of money than taking it to a dealership. And then the 90,000 mile is roughly the same. It's going to be an oil change. It's going to be a transmission filter change and fluid change, as well as it's also going to be replacing the spark plugs and rear differential fluid change. Sorry, got a fly in my throat or something. So the other thing, I have not done a lot of aftermarket stuff to this truck. As far as mechanically, I've got a 3-inch Flowmaster exhaust on the truck, and I have a K&N air filter, not a cold air intake setup, just the air filter. So as far as mechanically, I have not done anything to the truck, one, because I've got a 100,000 mile warranty on it, and I don't want to do too much and lose the warranty. The other thing is it does very well without, you know, camming it or any of that other stuff. I mean, I get plenty of power. It pulls well. One of the neat things about this transmission is it actually has 2 second gears. So it is a six-speed transmission, and it's got two sets of second gears. When you put it into tow haul, what it will do is make sure you don't go into cruise control unless you're absolutely just cruising. Also, or not cruise control, but into overdrive. But also what it does is it kicks it into the different second gear ratio. So it helps with kickdowns if you're pulling a pass or something like that. It really helps out the life of the transmission. These transmissions, as long as, like I said, as long as you take care of them, treat them right. They tend to be pretty bulletproof. As long as you make sure you're towing within the truck's vehicle towing capacity. You start, you know, towing 15,000 pounds on a regular basis, then you're probably going to run into trouble. But if you keep it under, I think the 8,000, I think it's 8,000 pounds is what this has a towing capacity of, 8 or 9,000 pounds. As long as you keep it in that range, you should have no issues with your motor whatsoever, engine or your transmission whatsoever. And then, like I said, if you're wanting to address any possible issues, get an aftermarket transmission cooler and keep it nice and cold, and you'll just extend the life of your engine or your transmission even further. So anyway, guys, this is just a brief video. I will add some footage of my truck in here, and you all have a great day. Thank you for tuning in.